Family and friends, welcome to the 33rd commencement ceremony of Bowling Green State University, Firelands College. Please rise and join us in honoring the 2018 graduates. Let the ceremony begin. Ladies and gentlemen, in keeping with the significance of this occasion, we ask that you observe a few simple courtesies. First, please do not obstruct the aisles to take photographs or congratulate the graduates. A professional photographer will be taking pictures of the graduates. Second, please follow the directions of the commencement marshals and ushers. And third, please do not leave until the alma mater has been sung at the conclusion of the ceremony. At the conclusion of the ceremony, the audience is asked to remain seated for the recessional while the platform participants, faculty, staff, and new graduates recess. Once the graduates have recessed, you may join them for a reception in the North Building Student Lounge. Finally, in honor of our candidates, please turn off your cell phones. Thank you. Please join us in welcoming the faculty of Bowling Green State University. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the President's Party, members of the Board of Trustees, Provost and Senior Vice President, Dean of BGSU Firelands, our commencement speaker, Alumni Affairs Officer, and the 12th President of Bowling Green State University, Dr. Rodney Rogers.
Good evening. I am Dr. Stephanie Walls, Associate Professor of Political Science and the BGSU Firelands Faculty Chair, and I have the honor of serving as the marshal for tonight's ceremony. Please remain standing and join in singing the national anthem under the leadership of Anna Berkmeyer, a rising sophomore majoring in music performance studies. Gentlemen, please remove your hats. Thank you, Ms. Berkmeyer, for that inspiring performance. Please be seated. Graduates, parents, families, spouses, partners, and friends, I have the honor on behalf of the faculty to welcome you to Bowling Green State University Firelands College's 33rd commencement ceremony. This occasion offers an opportunity to come together as a community of learners to both celebrate and reflect upon our graduates' wonderful academic accomplishments. For each graduate and for all of us, this is a significant day. It is now my great pleasure to present the president of Bowling Green State University, Dr. Rodney Rogers.
Thank you, Dr. Walls. Good evening, students, families, and friends of Bowling Green State University. This weekend, at our four commencements, 3 on the Bowling Green campus, and this evening, we celebrate a very momentous occasion in the lives of 2,341 graduates. It is my privilege to begin this evening's address by recognizing those who provide both the leadership and the academic integrity at Firelands College and Bowling Green State University. First, let me introduce the platform party. As I announce the names, please stand and remain standing, and I will ask you to hold your applause until the end. Members of the Board of Trustees: Megan Newlove, Chair. Daniel Keller, Vice Chair. Marilyn Isley. David O'Brien. Justin Harris, tonight's speaker. John Fisher, Provost and Senior Vice President. Andy Kurtz, Dean of the Firelands College. And Patty Crawford, Alumni Affairs Officer for the college. Let's give these folks a round of applause. You know, great universities are comprised of great faculty and mentors. They are the heart of our academic mission. Their teaching skills, research expertise, and involvement in the students' education are hallmarks of a BG experience. We are proud of their contributions to create and support the Bowling Green learning community and appreciate that they actively engage our students in valuable learning experiences, mentor them as professionals, and advise them in their academic and career pursuits. May I ask the faculty of Firelands College to please stand and be recognized. Thank you. You know, as we begin tonight's ceremony, I want to share a few interesting statistics about our graduates. As I mentioned, in this May 2018 graduating class, there are 2,341 candidates for degrees. At Firelands, there are 118 candidates for associate degrees and 32 candidates for bachelor's degrees. 30 Firelands students have earned honors based upon high grade point average. 14% of our graduates are students of color, and 65% are women. Of those students receiving bachelor's degree, the youngest is 21 and the oldest is 54. Of those students receiving associate's degrees, the youngest is 18 and the oldest is 61. Our students eligible for an associate degree through the College Credit Plus program are all 17 and 18 year old. As you can see, our graduates tonight range in age from 17 to 61, proving the young are definitely driven, while our older students show tenacity and prove the concept that one is never too old to learn. The value of the Bowling Green degree you're about to receive has never been higher. We continue to be ranked as a Tier 1 national university by U.S. News and World Report. The Economist ranks Bowling Green first among public universities in Ohio for boosting graduates' earnings, and Business Insiders recently ranked Bowling Green State University number one among all universities in the state of Ohio for quality and value. You know, at Bowling Green, we often say our students have an opportunity to belong, to stand out, and to go far. And that's more than just words, it's our promise. And this graduating class certainly embodies the promise of belong, as well as stand out. And our graduates at BGSU Firelands have been here during a pretty exciting time. They were some of the first students to utilize the new Allied Health and Science expansion, which offered state-of-the-art labs and enhanced learning opportunities. They have also participated in newly created student organizations which broaden horizons and celebrate the diversity of the campus. And they've witnessed the development of new academic programs like the soon-to-be-launched Bachelor of Science in Respiratory Care. All of this is to ensure that we have a strong learning community, a place where students can belong. That you're sitting here today, though, illustrates that you've thrived at Bowling Green. You have embraced the unique BG learning experience, developing research and leadership skills on your journey. You have a valuable, high-quality education that will frame your thinking for years to come. The respect that you have demonstrated for the ideas and values of others while you have achieved your degree will be with you the rest of your life. You know, as a Falcon, you have learned to think beyond the discoveries made by others and have empowered your imagination to shape your own future and to pursue new levels of excellence and discovery. You know, in short, you have the knowledge and tools to change the world. And as a graduate of a public university, that is a key component, helping us change the world for better. And in recognition of your accomplishments, I will now ask a number of students to literally stand up and stand out and be recognized. One, many of you have grown through co-curricular involvement and leadership on campus and beyond BGSU, such as studying abroad or completing an internship or a research project. If you have taken part in an opportunity that has provided you with leadership education, but not limited to student organizations, honoraries, advisory boards, internships, research projects, student government, or other types of experiential learning, please stand and be recognized. Great. Thank you. It is also important to recognize the service that you have provided to others outside of Bowling Green. As you know, Bowling Green State University is recognized nationally for the involvement of our students in service projects and community-based projects. Those experiences complement your classroom learning. I invite all students who have participated in some type of community service while a student to please stand and be recognized. Thank you. This evening's ceremony also signifies a new chapter in your lives. I have no doubt that you will go far. You have belonged, you have stood out, and you will go far. So I encourage you to seize the opportunities, take calculated risks, be involved in your community, support others, have fun, but never, ever stop learning. I want to thank you for choosing Bowling Green State University and spending your time with us. You know, I'm reminded of a quote from Bowling Green's fourth president, Dr. Ralph McDonald. This quote is inscribed in the Bowen Thompson Student Union on the Bowling Green campus. The quote is, "We are linked to this institution by invisible bonds that do not wither or dissolve." So we are linked to this institution by invisible bonds that do not wither or dissolve. Bowling Green will always be one of your homes, and you will forever be welcome as a part of the Falcon family. I ask you to stay engaged with both your classmates and the university that you have enriched, a university that is better because you chose to be here. You see, your success is our success. But our success is your success. We are forever linked to this institution. On behalf of the faculty and the entire Bowling Green community, I am honored to congratulate you. Go far and make us proud. Thank you. I now invite Dean Andy Kurtz to introduce our speaker for this evening. Dean Kurtz.
Thank you, Dr. Rogers. We have practiced a tradition for the last several years at BGSU Firelands, which honors the accomplishments of our graduates and gives voice to their experiences as students and members of the BGSU community. The faculty and staff nominate and select one graduating student who represents the best of BGSU Firelands and we invite that graduate to offer words of encouragement and advice to the graduating class. I am honored to introduce our student speaker for the 2018 commencement ceremony, Kaylee Shover. Kaylee is earning her Bachelor of Applied Health Science in Allied Health degree tonight, and she already holds an Associate of Science degree, which she earned from BGSU Firelands in 2016. In addition, she completed the paramedic program at Ehovi Adult Career Center at the age of 19 with certifications in advanced cardiac life support, pediatric advanced life support, and Ohio trauma triage. She went on to become the first female firefighter on the Milan Township Fire Department. She is currently applying to medical schools and plans to become an emergency room physician. Please join me in welcoming Kaylee Shover.
Thank you, Dean Kurtz, President Rogers, members of the Board of Trustees, and faculty, graduates, and guests. I'm honored to have been chosen to make the remarks on behalf of the class of 2018. It seems like yesterday that I was 15 and just starting my first classes here at Firelands. The Firelands campus really was a pivotal part of growing into the adult I am today, and I've loved the fact that we have grown together. With the addition of the new science wing, the new advanced degrees and classes being offered, I could not be more proud to be a Falcon, a Firelands Falcon. None of this would have been possible for any of us without a support system. So I'd like to extend a sincere thank you to parents, professors, tutors, significant others, other mentors, and Firelands staff who inspired us and helped make our dreams a reality. Well, we made it. I'm so very proud of every one of us. We did it. We powered through those nights that we thought we were too tired to study for those exams. We aced the topic that we thought we'd never understand, and the most important thing is we never gave up. So I'm going to try to keep this short so we can get to what we've literally all been waiting years for. Here's a few things I've learned on my 20 years on this earth. First, never underestimate, but never sweat the small stuff. Second, strive to be the best, but be content with being better than you were. If we all just try our best, we can truly achieve so much. So writers, write those wonderful stories, make those words dance, and leave your influence. Artists, mix those colors and bring those hues to life. Allow us to see in a different way and an alternate reality. To the education majors, raise our next group of Falcons, raise them right. To the science majors, find the answers to the problems that the world needs solved. Pursue that burning desire to learn our surroundings and what literally sustains our lives. The Firelands community is so proud of every one of you, and whatever you do, do your best, and please remember that is always enough. And finally, the one thing that is for certain is that we do not have forever to make our goals happen. So do it now. Take that trip that you've always wanted to take. Visit that place you've always wanted to visit and apply for that tough graduate program. Do what scares you, because what takes the most courage is what is usually worth doing. In the end, all we have is our memories and our legacies we leave behind, our footprints and marks on this world. So what do you say, class of 2018? I think today is a great day to start. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Shover. I now invite Provost and Senior Vice President, Dr. John Fisher, to introduce our commencement speaker.
Thank you, Dean Kurtz. Attorney, law director, community leader. Tonight's speaker, Justin Harris, earned an Associate of Applied Science degree in Respiratory Care Technology from BGSU Firelands in 2000, and a Bachelor of Applied Health Sciences in 2001. He earned a law degree from The Ohio State University. Mr. Harris began his legal career as an associate with a law firm in Dayton. In 2005, he returned to Sandusky to practice law and now serves as the law director for the city of Sandusky. He is an adjunct professor in the Legal Studies Business Department here at Firelands and is a member of the Firelands Alumni Board. Attorney, law director, community leader, and most importantly, a Falcon. Please join me in welcoming Justin Harris to the podium. Mr. Harris.
Thank you, Provost Fisher. Thank you, President Rogers, and good evening to the trustees, our honored guests, and our faculty here today in front of me. And to our graduates and friends and families assembled here, congratulations to you on this milestone of an accomplishment in your life. And let it be no mistake, this is no small success in life's journey. Speaking of journeys, I want to tell you about a journey that started about 20 years ago when I met a young man here on this very same campus. It would have been the spring of 1998, and the kid appeared dejected, confused, completely disheartened. When I asked him why he was disheartened, he said that he felt like a failure. The kid was barely 18 years old. He had his whole life in front of him. So you might be asking yourself, why would an 18-year-old feel like a failure? Come to find out, the kid was one of the smartest kids in his school system growing up. He was involved in almost every club and organization, excelled in athletics, and even scored in his 30s on his ACTs. And yet here he was starting college a semester after all of his peers in all of places Firelands High. Years prior, he thought he would be roaming the halls of NYU, Harvard, but BGSU Firelands, come on. I don't know about you folks, but I thought this kid thought a great deal of himself and far less of this fine institution that we all find ourselves in today. Frankly, I thought the kid was someone who was told his whole life that he was great, barely had to work on anything, and basically skated by his whole life on probably pure luck. And guess what? I called this kid out on that. His response to me was what I thought it would be. He blamed it on his divorced parents. He blamed it on the strange relationship he had with his father. He blamed it on the lack of money. He blamed his girlfriend at the time. He even blamed his three-month-old kid that he and his girlfriend recently had. I went from feeling sorry for the kid to feeling angry. Clearly, this kid had yet to experience what most of us here today supporting the graduates have experienced, and that's what we call life. I was angry because I was always taught that the value of an education, any education. I also knew all by probably watching Matt Damon and Good Will Hunting that you could probably get as good as education with $1.50 in late fees from the public library that you could from a $150,000 education at Harvard. I did what I felt was right at the time, and I challenged the kid to give BGSU Firelands a chance. The kid agreed and committed to BGSU Firelands. He gave Dean Kurtz's technical writing class a chance. He gave Dr. Genovese's microbiology class a chance, even though he was locked out numerous occasions for being a minute late. He gave his advisor, Dr. Daly, at the time she wasn't a doctor, a chance. Congratulations. He gave Mr. Moore a chance. He gave Dr. Adafi a chance. He gave Dr. Mruck a chance. He gave Ms. Pooter a chance. He gave Mr. Rourke a chance. And some other professors that aren't here with us today, but the professors here before you that have given you a chance. After committing to BGSU Firelands, the kid graduated and was ready for the next journey in his life, law school. The kid took what he learned here and applied it to law school at the Ohio State University Michael E. Moritz College of Law. He soon discovered that the knowledge passed down by these esteemed professors in front of us here today could be applied to law school and eventually the real world. He applied the lessons learned by these professors at a large firm out of Cleveland named Remiger Company LPA, and his journey eventually led him back to his hometown of Sandusky, where he currently serves as a law director. And as luck may have it, his journey led him back here to share in this joyous celebration that you guys are experiencing today and an opportunity to share his journey. As you could tell from the introduction, I didn't know the dynamics, but the kid that I met and was disappointed in, but gave into later in life was myself. And this kid committed to this university that never gave up on him, and here I am today. But during my time here, what I did learn was that commitment is that turning point in your life when you seize the moment and convert it into an opportunity to change your destiny. I learned that one of the best things you can do for yourself is to trust the process and commit without apology to the journey and not the outcome. When I look at the wealth of experience and knowledge possessed by these educators right here in front of me that has been passed on to you, as well as the enthusiastic faces that I see on your faces, I know that at least to this point you have committed to the journey and seized the opportunity to become successful. And make no mistake, every one of you have the potential to be successful, if not more successful, than the Harvard or Yale graduate, because you guys are BGSU graduates. Simply stay committed to yourself. And although I would love to give you one of a blueprint for the rest of your journey after you leave today, I can't, because each one of you have to walk your own journey. But I challenge each and every one of you to be addicted to bettering yourself and staying the course. And I can promise you one thing, if you continue to commit to yourself and invest in self-improvement, 5, 10, 20 years from now, you'll look up and you'll find yourself in places you could never have imagined. To the parents, children, family, friends, and loved ones here today, my challenge to you is to continue to encourage the graduates here today to stay committed and invested in themselves. Although we have our own lives, life journeys can sometimes be lonely, sometimes long, and sometimes unpredictable. But the travel along life's path sometimes seems a little bit easier when we have a companion for part of the ride. Simply stated, the joyous day may not have been possible for these folks in front of us today without you. And for that, I ask the graduates to give a round of applause for those who supported you on your journey, leading you here today. In closing, a famous tennis player by the name of Arthur Ashe once said, "Success is a journey, not a destination. The doing is often more important than the outcome." To the class of 2018, I again want to congratulate you on your success here today. But I want to remind you that the journey never ends. When you wake up tomorrow, continue to keep doing the things that helped you make it to the successful day in your life. And keep moving, my fellow travelers. Godspeed.
Commit to yourself. Thank you, Justin, for your inspirational remarks and the wisdom you've provided our graduates. I now invite Provost Fisher to present our students as candidates for the degrees to be granted this evening. Provost Fisher.
Thank you, President Rogers. Before I call upon Dean Kurtz to present our degree candidates, I would like to recognize those students who have excelled in their academic endeavors and are graduating with academic distinction and honors. This is indeed a great achievement for these graduates and their families. Bowling Green State University congratulates you for your commitment and for your success, and so I recognize the following students. There are 30 students receiving degrees with Latin honors this commencement at BGSU Firelands. To graduate cum laude, or with distinction, a student must have a cumulative grade point average of at least 3.5. With those graduating with the designation of cum laude or with distinction, please stand and be recognized. Congratulations. To graduate magna cum laude, a student must have a grade point average of 3.75. With those graduating with the designation of magna cum laude, please stand and be recognized. Congratulations. And finally, to graduate summa cum laude, or with highest distinction, requires a 3.9 grade point average. With those graduating with the designation of summa cum laude, or with highest honors, please stand and be recognized. Congratulations. And now I call upon Dean Kurtz to present the candidates for baccalaureate degrees and associate degrees from Firelands College.
Thank you, Provost Fisher. Will the marshals please escort the baccalaureate degree candidates to the stage? President Rogers and members of the Board of Trustees, on behalf of the faculty of the Firelands College and the deans of our sister colleges on the Bowling Green campus, I am pleased and honored to present these baccalaureate degree candidates and recommend them for degrees.
Kaylee Mary Shover, College of Health and Human Services, Bachelor of Applied Health Science. Jack M. Stone, College of Technology, Architecture, and Applied Engineering, Bachelor of Science and Technology, cum laude. Joshua Joseph Bradbury, College of Arts and Sciences, Bachelor of Liberal Studies. Alyssa Ryan, College of Arts and Sciences, Bachelor of Liberal Studies. Timothy J. Husk, College of Arts and Sciences, Bachelor of Liberal Studies. Joshua Edward Campbell, College of Business, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration. Erica Gail Kemplin, College of Business, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration. Shelby Marie Tillinghast, College of Business, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration. Marina Dolores Abel, College of Education and Human Development, Bachelor of Science in Education, cum laude. Ashley Rose Bond, College of Education and Human Development, Bachelor of Science in Education, cum laude. Stephanie Lee Boris, College of Education and Human Development, Bachelor of Science in Education. Macy Eileen Cross, College of Education and Human Development, Bachelor of Science in Education, magna cum laude. Julia Fikes, College of Education and Human Development, Bachelor of Science in Education. Sierra R. Gessner, College of Education and Human Development, Bachelor of Science in Education, cum laude. Cody James Gregory, College of Education and Human Development, Bachelor of Science in Education. Brooke Nicole Halleck, College of Education and Human Development, Bachelor of Science in Education, cum laude. Alexis Ann McCabe, College of Education and Human Development, Bachelor of Science in Education, magna cum laude. James C. Stewart, College of Education and Human Development, Bachelor of Science in Education, cum laude. Courtney Jo Workman, College of Education and Human Development, Bachelor of Science in Education, cum laude. Kelly Allison Zervalek, College of Education and Human Development, Bachelor of Science in Education. Stephanie Ann Panikvar, College of Health and Human Services, Bachelor of Science in Criminal Justice, summa cum laude. Heather Ann Chapman, College of Health and Human Services, Bachelor of Applied Health Science.
Will the marshals now please escort the associate degree candidates to the stage? President Rogers and members of the Board of Trustees, on behalf of the faculty of the Firelands College, I am pleased and honored to present these associate degree candidates and recommend them for degrees.
Kaylin K. Widman, Firelands College, Associate of Applied Science in Criminal Justice. Kara Ashley Noon, Firelands College, Associate of Applied Science in Inclusive Early Childhood Education with Distinction. Brett Austin Wamsley, Firelands College, Associate of Science. Gina Lee Terry, Firelands College, Associate of Science. Janine R. Cobbs, Firelands College, Associate of Science. Carrie Lynn Stewart, Firelands College, Associate of Science, Associate of Applied Science and Radiologic Technology with Distinction. Jackie Petrie, Firelands College, Associate of Applied Science and Radiologic Technology. Paige Madison Creakle, Firelands College, Associate of Science. Robert Anthony Sands, Firelands College, Associate of Applied Business and Business Management Technology, President's Award recipient. Hannah K. Rowe, Firelands College, Associate of Science. Kara D. Rising, Firelands College, Associate of Applied Science in Criminal Justice. Austin James Rising, Firelands College, Associate of Applied Science in Criminal Justice and Associate of Science. Carrie Ward, Firelands College, Associate of Applied Science in Radiologic Technology. Taylor Copas, Firelands College, Associate of Applied Science in Radiologic Technology. Corey Bellamy, Firelands College, Associate of Applied Science in Radiologic Technology and Associate of Arts. Sierra Holiday, Firelands College, Associate of Applied Science in Radiologic Technology. Michaela Adriana Koch, Firelands College, Associate of Applied Science in Radiologic Technology. Megan Louise Chafin, Firelands College, Associate of Science. Erin Paige Nason, Firelands College, Associate of Applied Business and Business Management Technology. Taylor Ann Murphy, Firelands College, Associate of Technical Study. April Dawn Mercedes Buzan, Firelands College, Associate of Technical Study. Ashley E. Lewis, Firelands College, Associate of Science. Hannah J. Fraley, Firelands College, Associate of Technical Study. Kayla D. Miller, Firelands College, Associate of Science. Stephen M. Bechtel, Firelands College, Associate of Applied Science in Electrical, Electronic Engineering Technology. Andrew J. Taylor, Associate of Applied Science, Electrical, Electronic Engineering Technology. Rebecca Michelle Cover, Firelands College, Associate of Science. Tyler Lee Voltz, Firelands College, Associate of Science. Chloe Sue Fraley, Firelands College, Associate of Technical Study. Benjamin Adam Ernie, Firelands College, Associate of Applied Science and Criminal Justice. Emily Nicole Downing, Firelands College, Associate of Arts. Lindsay Ann Dillander, Firelands College, Associate of Applied Science and Human Services. Kelly A. Copsey, Firelands College, Associate of Applied Science in Inclusive Early Childhood. Carla Marie Shaver, Firelands College, Associate of Applied Science in Inclusive Early Childhood Education. Chandrell Nicole Collins, Firelands College, Associate of Applied Science in Inclusive Early Child Education. Angelita N. Gonzalez, Firelands College, Associate of Applied Science in Inclusive Early Child Education. Felicia Starr Kane, Firelands College, Associate of Applied Science in Inclusive Early Child Education. Stephen W. Friend, Firelands College, Associate of Applied Science in Radiologic Technology. Rokia Toure Miller, Firelands College, Associate of Technical Study. Ashley Marie D'Agostino, Firelands College, Associate of Arts. Maya Ilana Smith, Firelands College, Associate of Science.
Tonight, we are also honored to recognize a special group of students from area high schools who participated in the BGSU Firelands College Credit Plus program. This program provides an opportunity for high school students to earn credit for taking college-level courses while at the same time fulfilling all the requirements for their high school diplomas. The students who we recognize tonight have earned 62 credit hours and will be eligible to receive an associate's degree after graduating from high school next month. Will the marshals please bring the College Credit Plus students to the platform? President Rogers and members of the Board of Trustees, on behalf of the faculty of BGSU Firelands, I am pleased and honored to present our College Credit Plus program students.
Haley Hoffman, Firelands College, Associate of Arts. Kyle David Baker, Firelands College, Associate of Science and Associate of Applied Science and Criminal Justice. Braxton Reed Joseph Friend, Firelands College, Associate of Science. Andrew Carl Kramer, Firelands College, Associate of Science. Leah Kruel, Firelands College, Associate of Science. Samantha Flieger, Firelands College, Associate of Science. This concludes the recognition of degree candidates.
Thank you, Dean Kurtz. Will all the degree candidates please rise? Let's give them one more round of applause.
Yeah.
Chair Newlove, it is my privilege to present these candidates to you. On behalf of their faculty, advisors, and deans, I hereby recommend that degrees be conferred upon them as indicated in the official program. Thank you.
On the recommendation of the faculty and by virtue of the authority vested in me as chair of the Board of Trustees, I hereby confer upon each of you the appropriate degrees as listed in the official program with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities appertaining thereto. Baccalaureate and associate degree graduates, this is the appropriate moment for the symbolic change of the tassel from right to left. Congratulations, BGSU graduates. Graduates, please be seated. President Rogers.
Okay. Thank you, Chair Newlove. So I have two last Bowling Green assignments for you that I hope you will complete, okay? Just two last assignments. So one, Bowling Green State University's missions, we state that we prepare you for lifelong career growth, lives of engaged citizenship, and leadership in a global society. Earning your degree tonight places you in a very select group of people in the world. And so here's my request for you. You have immense responsibility. You've been educated, you have earned your degree. Many of you will continue on with additional education, and I encourage you to do that. But I also encourage you to continue to be a leader in your profession, to be a leader in your community, in the nation, and the world. We wish to each of you to continue to lead a meaningful and an engaged life. Two, so that's the first thing you want to do. Lead a meaningful and engaged life. One small assignment. Two, we have been putting the spotlight on you tonight, I know. But there is this other group that I think we should honor. And it is my pleasure to make sure we do that. So I'm asking all the parents, spouses, partners, and children of the graduates, please rise and remain standing. And would anyone else who has assisted these graduates in any way please stand up? Okay, graduates, these individuals have made a difference in your lives. Thank you. It is now my pleasure to introduce Patricia Crawford, Alumni Affairs and Development Officer of Firelands College. Patricia.
Thank you, President Rogers and members of the Board of Trustees. Graduates, you are now officially Bowling Green State University alumni. Let me be the first to welcome you to a wonderful and amazing network of more than 175,000 alumni across the nation and the world. We are active citizens. We invest our time, talent, and treasure to support each other and our vibrant alma mater. Some of you have already invested in the university by contributing to the Forever Falcon campaign. Know that through your financial gift, you are supporting future generations of learners and have improved this university, and we thank you. Please know that the most significant advantages of Bowling Green education is your lifelong connection to a supportive network. Wherever you go, whatever you do, you are always a Bowling Green Falcon, and Bowling Green will always welcome you home. I now invite you to join us in a longstanding Bowling Green tradition. We will close our ceremony with our university's alma mater, led by Miss Anna Berkmeyer. The words to the alma mater may be found on the back page of your program. Please stand. Thank you.
audience members, please be seated for the recessional and remain seated while the platform participants, faculty, and graduates recess. Immediately following the recessional, we ask that you join us in the North Building Student Lounge for refreshments. Thank you, and congratulations to all.